Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to yet another episode of Mycareer in Wwe 2K17. I, of course, am JDL, John Dave Shell Layfield. If you missed the last episode, you missed something from JDL. JDL kind of went crazy at the end of his match on the main event, and apparently he's coming out tonight to address the crowd. I gotta imagine that something's on his mind. I mean, we saw him go crazy last week, attacking Samoa Joe with a weapon after the match, just going berserk. So I don't know what we're gonna see here tonight. Because look at me, I'm a work of art, sculpted perfection, up there with the works of Michelangelo, Monet, Rembrandt, and Van Gogh. Any of them would kill to have a specimen like me. I am a masterpiece. So, bit of a odd comment to start things off from JDL. I mean, I'm not sure what's going on here exactly. Says the entire WWE locker room is afraid right now. Do you know why? It's because they realize that a new threat has risen to turn their dreams into nightmares, to turn their joyous existence into an unimaginable maelstrom. There is a new lion amongst the lambs. Me. I mean, that's pretty accurate with what we saw last week, or when he was attacking Samoa Joe, just acting like a lamb going crazy, or a lion going crazy there, really. WWE is really the WWE me. It's all about me, and it exists because of me. I want the name changed. I want my name in the company name. I want billboards, arrays, private jets. I want to be treated like a king. I mean, it's a bit odd to be hearing from JDL. I mean, it's not that odd. He is a bit, selfish, I guess. However, he's all about himself, so I mean, it's not too odd, I guess, but it's definitely kind of weird there, because there's only so much time a WWE superstar has to rise to the occasion and compete with the best. I'm right here, risen and ready for whatever you want to throw at me. So what are you waiting for? This thoroughbred is ready for the triple crown. I mean, that's kind of a strong statement for somebody who has yet to even capture a championship in the WWE so far, but, to each their own, I suppose. If you see me in the back, know that you're looking at the guy who's going to take your spot. Not just take it, but step on you to get it. So, if you put your hand out and I smack it away, don't take it personally. I'm just, better than you. I mean, those are pretty strong words after what we saw last week with that attack on Joe after the match. That's pretty strong stuff from JDL there. I mean, I guess one has to wonder what exactly is going to be happening heading forward. Definitely a strong showing last week, and I guess it's a pretty selfish comment here tonight on NXT. But after this match, or after this promo, he's got himself another tag team match. It's him and it's a rematch of I think it was last week, last NXT, when it's JDL and Brody Tyson versus the Vaude Villains here tonight on NXT. JDL, of course, being accompanied to the ring by Alexa Bliss. Not his main squeeze, so to speak, Becky Lynch. She's off doing some other stuff, so Alexa's the one that's accompanying him during his WWE career. Yes, there's the coat, there's the hat, there's the pyro. JDL looking all confident as ever. Got the black and white of the NWO. Looking like a star. Now, it's kind of an interesting reason why JDL is accompanied to the ring by Alexa Bliss. They kind of struck a deal, contract, if you will, that that said that Vex gets to accompany JDL to all the ProJaked Universe shows and be, you know, the helper that he needs there at those shows with all his paperwork and all of his other stuff there, while Alexa Bliss gets to be his manager during his actual WWE career. So, I mean, they seem to struck a deal, and it seems to be working out really well. So we'll have to see how that goes heading forward, see if anything changes in the future with that at all. But, I mean, for now, we've got JDL in the ring. We've got his tag team partner, Brody Tyson, the kid from the Performance Center that he's kind of picked up and taken under his wing. And, we're going to have to see if this tag team can get another victory against the Vaudevillains. Rated fourth in the NXT tag team rankings at the moment. Well, technically, yeah, fourth, because there's three teams ahead of them and then the champions. Haven't really seen any sort of a rivalry really get started for JDL so far in his career, though. He attacked, he had a little bit of a thing with Big Cass for a while, but that seems to have ended already. And he he's fought Samoa Joe a lot recently. I'm not sure if anything's going to end up turning around because of that. But, so he's in the ring there with Brody Tyson, and he's awaiting the entrance of his opponents for the night. The Vaudevillains, Aiden English and Simon Gotch. I mean, last week on NXT, I'm pretty sure it was last week on NXT. The two teams had a pretty good match, a pretty good back and forth match. But in the end, JDL got the victory. So we'll have to see if the same happens here tonight, or if something changes. I mean, obviously, a win over the Vaudevillains, who I believe are the third ranked team in the tag team ranking. So it would be kind of good to get that victory over them and try to move up in the rankings, try to get himself towards a tag team championship goal. As we see Simon Gotch going up the ramp, and now he's coming back down the ramp. Aiden English, Simon Gotch coming down to the ring. We're going to have to see. I'm kind of interested to see what exactly is going to go on with JDL heading forward. I mean, he's sounded a bit selfish there, really, in his promo, and he's kind of calling out the entire WWE locker room, which, I mean, we've come to expect from JDL, but there seemed to be a little bit more of a veracity to it, more an angry heel in a way, almost as if he's feeling disrespected about the fact that, you know, he's a 26-time American Border Patrol champion, and yet he is having to face who he deems kind of pathetic, unknown people, I guess, so to speak. So we'll have to see if anything comes, you know, goes on beyond that. So we'll have to see if he tries to attack one of these guys after this match, or if he tries to do some dastardly, you know, some attack on main event or whatever ends up happening. So, but here we got JDL that come starting the match with Tyson out on the outside. We got English starting the match with Simon Gotch on the outside there. JDL immediately the kick and then big scoop slam as the fans start chanting NXT. And JDL with a brain buster on Aiden English. And this is going to be an interesting match here. Oh, this is with the elbow, but got the second elbow that time. And a big suplex. Look at that. JDL just taking it to Aiden English here tonight. Just not letting up. One move after another. Look at this. Just, oh, man. The shots there. Shots every. Oh, look at that. What the? He's attacking Simon Gotch for no reason. I'm not sure what's going on there. JDL's just—I don't even know. Not quite seeing the. I mean, a different, you know, more angrier version of JDL. It seems like Aiden English finally trying to mount a little bit of offense in this match, taking it to JDL as he's down here, but. JDL, big knee lift right there. Just taking it to him. Stomping away as Aiden English apparently took one of those stomps really hard. Oh, Aiden English with a reversal there. A big DDT. I'm like, yeah, Aiden English is tagging out. JDL trying to get to his feet. Punched by Gotch there. Big Michinoku driver there. And JDL came out with a lot of offense, but he doesn't seem to be looking so good right now. Simon Gotch with a disrespect. The disrespectful push-ups and everything. JDL looks like he took offense to that because he went for his discus elbow there, but it got caught. Big suplex there. Look at that, Simon Gotch just taunting. I mean, JDL's struggling here. He's not getting it going over. He's getting beat up right now. We'll have to see. He's going to try to fire back here. Kick right there. And up in the air. Brainbuster. What? Wait. Did we just see what I think we just saw? What is he doing? Referee's trying to get Alexa brought a chair in. Referee was getting rid of it there. I don't know if he was actually going to go for it or what was going to happen there. As we got a superplex attempt here, but JDL fight it off. Pushes Gotch down to the mat. Kicking at him there. I mean, that was a bit unexpected. The fact that Alexa brought that chair in and it looked like he was going to use it, but and I don't know what was going to happen there exactly. Oh man, what a Northern Lights driver there by JDL. Gotch with a reversal. Taking him down to the mat, just working on that arm. Look at that, just the disrespect. The disrespect there by Simon Gotch. Aiden English getting tagged back in here I don't know. I think maybe JDL's selfish attitude here is costing him at this point. English misses with the elbow. Big kick to the back there. Sends him off the rope, though. Sends him to the outside. Oh, what a punch. Knocking him down to the mat. Alexa helping him up on the outside. Look at this. He's going after him, though. And a big... Oh, man. Like a half Nelson suplex into a neck breaker there. JDL is just taking it to Aiden English here on the outside. Clubbing blow across the back. What's he going for here? Oh man! Big face buster there. JDL's just leaving him, just beating him up out there. The referee's up to a six count. Oh, looked like he was going for something there, but I think Aiden English reversed it. The two are fighting on the outside here. I mean, Alexa Bliss tried to get involved there, but as we saw, it didn't work out too well for him. Aiden English with a reversal there in the corner. Coming out. Sunset flip. One of the most dangerous moves in wrestling, as we know it from the ProJaked universe. JDL trying to fight back, though. Goes for a thing there. And Brody Tyson just out there on the apron just taunting as... Oh, look at this. There it is. Alexa Bliss getting involved. Distracting him when JDL gets to his feet. And a big Michinoku driver anyway. And the cover. But Alexa Bliss is up on the apron. Alexa Bliss is up on that apron. And she's been ejected. She's been thrown out of the match. And the referee goes down now. JDL is not happy about that. What's this? What the? Well, he tried for a chair shot there. He missed. Aiden English, though, with a big back suplex. Now, this match is broken into chaos. Look at that. Brody Tyson now getting shot. Dazing Aiden English. What in the heck has gone on in this match? There goes that chair again. And JDL's down. And now Koch tried to go to the top, and JDL, Brody Tyson struck him. There's another shot there. JDL's not getting up, though. I don't know what's going on here. Koch going up. It gets taken off there. Look at that. It's as if it was a plan all along or something there. JDL's still dazed, though. I don't know if he's playing possum or what's going on here. Koch is just watching, confused right now. And, oh, God! Just a big boot right out of it. My God. Oh, look at this. It looked like he was playing possum because there's the American slice of apple pie. Off the ropes. What a kick. Going to the middle rope here. And that senton kind of connecting with his legs there. I mean, this is what has been going on in this match right now. Referee goes down. JDL tries for something there, but misses, I guess. Oh, God. Taken down. And look at this. Look at this. The referee's down, though. What? You know what? I don't even know what to think about at this point in this match. This has been complete chaos. Just chaos like no other. There's a big boot to Koch running. Oh, God. Busting Simon Gotch's head wide open. Look at this. Just taunting Koch now. I mean, what is going on in this match? Oh, God. Here we go. Here we go. Photo finish. Koch is laid out. English gets taken down. Goes for the cover. Here's one, two. Well, that was certainly a bit of a chaotic match, but I guess Brody Tyson and JDL pick up the victory, despite Tyson not even getting tagged into the match. That was, I don't even know what was going on. It was almost as if Brody Tyson was just like a second manager for JDL, just providing a few shots there to the vaudevillains and trying to catch them off guard. But it seemed like it was more of a handicap match. I mean, I don't know what JDL's issue is there. Last time we saw him go, you know, kind of one-on-one or one-on-two against a tag team like that, he lost Enzo Amore and Colin, Enzo and Cass. But, I mean, here tonight, he got the victory there. So, you know, I guess we'll have to see what's going to happen heading forward as we go into main event here in the second week of June. And eventually, well, we know about the history with him. As a rematch of NXT TakeOver is about to happen here between Finn Balor and JDL there. So that'll definitely be interesting to see. So, I mean, I don't know, you know, I'm guessing that's going to be a good back and forth match there, but we'll have to see what ends up happening here. We get the intro for the main event. I mean, after what we saw there on NXT there, going up against the Vaudevillains, kind of a one-on-two handicap match kind of thing. Almost it can be interesting to see what happens heading forward. But here we are, main event time. Going to be taking on Finn Balor yet again, and you know, who knows, he might end up trying to attack Finn Balor after the match. I don't even know. JDL has just been going a bit crazy there. We're coming from Long Beach, California here for main event tonight. So yeah, we get to deal with this whole bunch of fun, I guess. It's going to be interesting to see what ends up happening as we get to as we continue with the career of JDL. Not sure what to say at this point. I mean, he's definitely shown this different attitude. I mean, he was, you know, like I said, he's always kind of selfish and everything, but he seems to be taking it to another level here on, here in the last couple of shows. We got the WWE logo there. We got, is that Jason Jordan in an interview there? Oh, God! What the heck is this? Why is this happening? JDL attacking Jason Jordan backstage. What is going on with that? Just slamming him into the wall. What in the heck is going on here? A big leg drop there. What is going on? I think JDL's just gone off the deep end almost. I mean, these two haven't even interacted, to my knowledge. They've never dealt with each other in here, to my knowledge. But here we've got JDL just beating the heck out of Jason Jordan with a steel chair in the back. I don't know what happened there. Jordan trying to fight back. I mean, at this point, doing the best he can. He takes him into the little pillar thing where the interview's done. Oh, JDL runs into a dropkick there. Jason Jordan's just trying to fight back, just do the best he can to, stop whatever was going on here. As JDL gets slammed into the wall now. I don't know what happened here. I don't know why JDL's going after Jason Jordan. I've been beat up in the process right now. But I don't understand what's going on here. Big back suplex there. JDL's attempt here to go after Jason Jordan for whatever reason. Oh God, a DDT there in the back. I don't know what has caused this to happen. I don't know what's going on, but oh God. Oh God, here we go. The Outsider's Edge, taught to him by the NWO Scott Hall. On the outside, Jordan looks out. He's out. And JDL's just yelling at him. What has happened? JDL has just lost his mind. I don't even know what's going on here. Well, I mean, it's main event of the main event. JDL's going one-on-one with Finn Balor here tonight. He's got Alexa Bliss in his corner. I don't even know what to say at this point. JDL has just gone into some crazy mode. Maybe this is carried over frustration from what's been happening in the ProJaked universe about Bennett accepting that challenge for Survivor Series and the livelihood of the NWO possibly at risk. I mean, that's what this is carried over from. After all, JDL is a member of the NWO. He is the voice of the NWO. So, I mean, maybe that's what it's carrying over from. Maybe that's just so much frustration built up from that whole thing that he's just taking it out here in his WWE career. I mean, look at that. Just a focused look as he comes to the ring. Not really any emotion. But, I mean, we saw the match that these two had at NXT TakeOver. We saw JDL and Finn Balor have a 5-star match there, NXT TakeOver. And one has to wonder if it's going to happen again here tonight on main event. I apologize. I'm still in shock. I don't know what caused that thing with Jason Jordan. I mean, I know that I'm pretty sure that Jordan and Chad Gable, better known as American Alpha, is like number two in the rankings of the NXT Tag Team Division, maybe. So maybe he was motivated by that. I'm not 100% sure there, but as we've got the non-demon form of Finn Balor coming out to the ring now. But this is gonna be an interesting match here tonight. I'm not sure. I apologize for starting over my words like this, but this is, I'm not even sure what to think at this point. It's, I guess that maybe it's the ranking thing. Maybe that's the motivation behind Jason Jordan, or maybe Jason Jordan was saying some bad stuff about JDL. I don't even know, but after what we saw at NXT there, JDL almost getting himself disqualified a couple times, and then that attack, one has to wonder what's even on JDL's mind here tonight as he gets ready to go up against the man he fought at NXT TakeOver, Finn Balor. Balor looking confident, showing off his six-pack abs, apparently. It's just really, he's really happy about those abs. Definitely a bit confused as to what's happening with JDL heading forward, but we get to see those abs again. By God, those abs. JDL's just walking past him out there. He's just like, whatever, I'm keeping an eye on you. And Alexa's slowly walking around. Alexa clapping for some reason. I don't know why she's... Maybe she's mocking. I think it's a mocking clap there. She's mockingly clapping for Finn Balor. Look at that JDL on the outside there, just standing there with his arms crossed, not even bothering to look at Balor. Just looking off to the side, not even wanting to look at the man. I don't know what's going to happen. I really don't know what's going to happen here tonight. But they could end up having another 5-star match. JDL can end up attacking Finn Balor again after the match. I don't even know what's going to happen there. But here we go. We're about to see this. JDL been worn out already. The big scoop slam to start off the match. I mean, one has to wonder, if that little fight with Jason Jordan just a little bit ago, big brain buster there. One has to wonder if that fight with Jason Jordan backstage just a little bit ago is going to have any wear and tear on JDL. I mean, that was a pretty back and forth. Jason Jordan did get some moves in back out there and tried to fight back. As a big German suplex there from JDL. JDL just dragging Finn Balor to the middle of the ring. Backing off. Finn's getting to his feet. Oh, God, what a knee to the side of the head. Oh, God, what a big boot there, too. Good Lord. Just taking it to Finn Balor right here. Finn Balor's just looking beat up right now. Look like he's going for a big haymaker, but Balor was able to counter. Tried going for a suplex or something, but JDL fighting him off. Big punch there. And what are we going to see here? Oh, look at that. A slingshot Falcon Arrow there. JDL to the top. Big senton there. I mean, this is looking oh God, a super kick. This is looking nothing like that TakeOver match. JDL's just lost his mind. It seems to be taking it to Finn Balor here. Look at that big kick. Oh God, another running boot. Staring the man down. I don't even know what. I mean, Balor's clearly an innocent victim in all this, but JDL's just going crazy. Look at that big suplex there. Just staring down at the man. Tries to kick him, but misses. Oh, God, another running big boot. I mean, Balor's got to be getting hurt at this point. JDL calling for something there. And, oh God, already? Well, American slice of apple pie already on Finn Balor. Balor's kind of close on that ropes there, but I guess not close enough. We got two. Balor kicks out. JDL's... I don't know if that was true. If that was true pain, or if that was true disbelief, or if it was just mocking disbelief. He hits a big air raid siren there. And, oh, God! Busted Finn Balor open. What is going on? JDL's lost his damn mind. Good Lord, what is this? What? No. Oh, my God. He hit him with his own finisher. He hit him with his own. Oh, my. One, two. What the heck has happened? Good Lord. JDL just lost his mind there. Just wouldn't let up on Finn Balor. Look at that. What has happened? I don't even know. Oh, God. Oh, God. Here we go again. What's he doing? What's he going to do this time? What's he? Oh, God. He's got that black baseball bat. Oh, God. To the gut. Look at this. Just shot after shot. This is reminiscent of what happened last week on Main Event. Just taking it to Samoa Joe. The referee's trying to call for help. The referee just got clocked. That's going to end up being a fine. What in the hell has gotten into JDL? Good Lord. Super kick again. That's it. What has happened? JDL has gone berserk. This is insanity, ladies and gentlemen. I don't even know what's going on here. That was like a 3 or 4 minute match. JDL just tore Finn Balor apart. I don't even know what to think at this point. I really don't. But here we are heading into week 3 of June, and well, there you go. As a result of what happened on Main Event there, it's gonna be JDL going one-on-one with Chad Gable in the Main Event, with Jason Jordan in Chad Gable's corner and Brody Tyson in JDL's corner. But I mean, my God, just what has happened? I don't even know. I'm not even gonna try to venture a guess, but ladies and gentlemen, that's been another week in the career of JDL. I guess he's just completely lost his mind. We'll have to see what's going to happen heading forward. But for now, we're just going to have to continue to be in disbelief. Just continue to be in surprise and shock as to what the heck is going on. I don't really know what to say at this point. It's been a chaotic week in the WWE career of JDL. That's all we're going to have for here tonight, though. Be able to see another week go by on Monday. Until then, I will see you all.